Hi, I'm Laura, and I'm on the Chrome accessibility team at Google. In this video, I'm going to show you some ways to browse Chrome for Windows using only the keyboard. I'm also going to show you some ways to find more resources if you'd like additional information. So let's start by talking about how to browse web pages. You may already know that you can browse a page at least three different ways: using the arrow keys, the page up and page down keys, or the home and end keys. But did you know that you can also scroll down whole sections of a page by pressing the spacebar? Once you reach the end of a page, press Shift with the spacebar to scroll back up. To move around the page, jumping from one clickable thing to another, press Tab. And to move backwards, Shift Tab. Next, you can open a shortcut menu using just the keyboard. It's also called the context menu, and it's a list of commands that are related to a task that you're doing or the area of the screen where your keyboard focus is. To open this context menu using only your keyboard, press the application key. If your keyboard has it, it's to the right of the spacebar. If you don't have the application key on your keyboard, try Shift and F10. Now, I use the arrow keys to navigate through these items and press Enter to choose something from the menu. If I want to close this menu, I can simply press Escape. Escape is also handy for closing other things, like dialog boxes. And Alt Home is the fastest way to your default homepage. You can set your default homepage in Chrome settings. Next, let's talk a bit about bookmarks. To toggle whether or not the bookmarks bar shows in Chrome, I press Ctrl+Shift+B, as in bookmarks. For these next shortcuts, I'm going to leave the bookmarks bar showing. Now I want to bookmark this page, so I'll press Ctrl+D, which will open the bookmarks dialog. I can choose the suggested bookmark name or rename it, and once I'm ready, press Done. Next, notice that by pressing F6, I can switch focus between the address bar, the bookmarks bar if it's showing, and the main web page content. So if I press F6 once, I'm in the address bar. Now I can use the Tab key, or Shift Tab, to move back and forth between the browser tools, the address bar, and any extension icons that I have. To select one, I press Enter. Now I can press F6 again, and now the focus is on the bookmarks bar. I can use the Tab or arrow keys to navigate, and again press Enter to select. There are a lot of keyboard shortcuts in Windows. Luckily, there's a quick way to look them up so you don't have to memorize them all to get the most out of Chrome on your Windows computer. Just press F1 to pull up the Chrome Help Center. Finally, I'm going to close the browser now. I can do this either by pressing Alt+F4 or by pressing Ctrl+Shift+Q. All right, that's all for now. To provide our team with feedback or ask any questions, join our Google group and send us an email at chrome-accessibility@googlegroups.com. To learn more about Google accessibility as a whole, check out google.com/accessibility. To sign up for user studies, to explore new features, and to help shape Google products, go to google.com/usability. Also, look out for additional videos for more ways to make Chrome easier to use. Again, I'm Laura, and on behalf of myself and our entire Chrome accessibility team, thanks for watching. And don't forget, we have a handful of other videos about Chrome accessibility. Check them out here.